So Troubles is a novel set in the north of Ireland in 1975. It's about a young Catholic teacher called Cushla Lavery. So by day she works in a school. She teaches a class of 7-year-olds, and in the evening she helps out in the bar that her family owns in the town. And it's there that she meets a man who's very unlike the men who normally come into the bar. So he is a lot older than her. He is a Protestant to her Catholic, which shouldn't matter, but in that time and place it did matter because of, I suppose, just sectarian tension and also the escalation of violence. And so she meets him and they begin a relationship, which is a very bad idea. I suppose the period of time that's now known as the Troubles began in late 1968, early 1969, when some students in Queen's University in Belfast took to the streets to protest what they saw as a lack of civil rights for the Catholic community and for poor people generally. And that was responded to by very severe violence from the police and later the British Army. And within maybe 1 or 2 years, it had escalated into a full-blown sort of guerrilla sectarian conflict. Also, there continued to be quite a lot of state violence as well. So the book was originally conceived as a love story, and I didn't think I was writing a book about the Troubles, and I never wanted to write a book about the Troubles. But once I placed the characters in 1975 and began to remember what it was like to live in the north of Ireland then, I found that the Troubles affected everywhere they went, everything they did, in a way that I had forgotten. So I lived in the north of Ireland as a child until I was 12 in 1979, when my family left. And really, I suppose when I tried to remember what my childhood was like, it really was about anxiety, and fear and tension. It wasn't. I think the love story came first, rather than the Troubles. I think that maybe Cushla, the main character, is very much derived from the young women who were around me when I was growing up. So my mother was 19 when I was born, and she has sisters. And for a while, my aunt, my father's sister, lived with us. And so I was surrounded by these young women who, on the one hand, they were full of life and very independent-minded, but they were also part of a Catholic community which expected them to be quiet and to stay at home, with their mother and father until some nice Catholic man came along who wanted to marry them. And I suppose for me, Cushla it's the 1970s, so she still lives in a world like that, but she's aware that in the broader world that things have become more permissive, and also she's educated. So I suppose I wanted to see what would happen if I put a young woman like that, in a situation where there was temptation. I wanted to see what she might do. So when I was writing Troubles, I became aware of things that I hadn't fully understood when I was a child and living there about the way that the class system operated in the north of Ireland. And I think that this is maybe common with other places where there is a division on other lines. So in this case, it was on religious lines, and the Catholic community were generally at a disadvantage to the Protestant community. And I suppose Cushla, the main character, within the little class system that she lives in the Catholic community, her family are at the top. But when she leaves that and has a relationship with Michael and meets his friends, then she realizes that she's not really so posh at all.